On a lonely Texas highway back in 1989, Don Piper saw two things in quick succession. First, a big rig headed straight for his car, and then the gates of heaven.
In 1989, Don Piper was instantly killed when his Ford Escort was crushed in a head-on collision. Paramedics covered his mangled body with a tarp. Then a pastor stopped and asked paramedics if he could pray for Don.
I walked over by the door, great physical damage on the outside, and I laid my hands on him and began to pray for him.
As the pastor knelt over Don's body, a sound came from beneath the tarp. Don wasn't dead. For the 10th anniversary of his book, 90 Minutes in Heaven, Don shares the vivid memories about his remarkable near-death experience.
And joining us now is a man who likes to say he's back by popular demand, Don Piper. Well, back by popular demand because of all the people that were praying for you. Don, it's good to see you. Walk us through what happened that day.
Well, I'm honored to be here very much. Thank you. People prayed and I lived. I was on my way to church to teach a Bible study on a Wednesday, and the 18-wheeler crossed the center stripe and hit me on this rural bridge in the middle of nowhere. And word reached my church that I had been in an accident, but not that I was a fatality, because my family had not been notified. They started praying. Mm. One of the pastors who was with the same conference with me was behind me. He came upon the accident, and God spoke to him and said, pray for the man in the red car, which was me. Mm. He got permission to get in the car, prayed for me. And as he's praying over my dead body, 90 minutes after the truck hit me and killed me, he's singing the great hymn, What a Friend We Have in Jesus, over my dead body. I've been dead an hour and a half, and suddenly, as he sings it, I start singing it with him. And he got out of the car really fast.
I bet.
He did, yeah. And told everybody I was alive.
And when I was reading in your book, they didn't really believe him at first.
No, they thought it was his imagination, because
yeah.
Four paramedics had pronounced me dead.
Four.
And they were waiting for the coroner, obviously, to come and take the body away. And so everyone, to say the least, was stunned by this turn of events. Then they had to figure out how to get me out of that horrific mashed car and to take me to a hospital.
Now, before you started singing with the pastor, you were in heaven.
I
had gone to the gates of heaven. Tell us about that.
Well, of course, there are 12 of them. There's three on each side of the city, the four walls of the city. It was magnificent. It really was a gate made of pearl. I wouldn't have believed this could happen until it happened to me.
And you think this was a real visitation?
Oh, it was.
Not something your body was just...
More real than anything I've experienced since. And, yeah. and when I came back, of course, I had 34 operations, was in a hospital for 13 months. That was real. But heaven's more real than that. The emotions, the feeling, the reality of being with the people who had preceded me in death.
Who was the first person that you saw and recognized?
My grandfather. Mm. I had been with him when he died. We were very, very close. I just adored him. And he died tragically of a heart attack one night, and I rode in the ambulance with him.
Wow.
So I was devastated when I lost him, and he was there to greet me when I died here. He was the first person I saw, and he looked good. You want to look good, heaven is where you want to be. He extended his hands to me, and he was missing fingers here on earth.
Mm.
And I looked down at the hands that held me when I was a little boy, and all of his fingers were there.
Wow.
And he said, in a language I've never heard before but fully understood, welcome home, Donnie, which is what he called me when I was here. I knew where I was when I saw him.
And you said you saw another lady. I don't remember the relation, but in real life, she didn't have teeth. But in heaven, she had the most gorgeous smile you'd ever seen.
It was my great-grandmother, yes. She had osteoporosis. She was very stooped as a result of her bones having collapsed. She was a good 6 inches taller in heaven. And... she smiled at me with her real smile. I'd never seen it before. She had dentures, and she didn't wear them very often.
That's amazing. Well, you talk about the music and the colors and the sounds and the love that you felt in heaven was something that you said was hard to write about in a book because there really aren't any human words to describe.
We don't have earthly words here to describe heaven. And many have taken a shot at it and done a good job of talking how glorious heaven is, but really think it's heaven. It's not here, and it's not like here. The best thing about heaven, beyond the colors and the aromas and the music and the angels and all those, is you're with God. You are with God, and we will be His people, and He will be with us forever. It's glorious.
Now, Don, it wasn't easy coming back. You spent more than 100 days in the hospital. You were in more pain than really you can even talk about, and you're still recovering. Tell us about the injuries.
Well, I had brain damage. My wife still thinks I have brain damage, and that comes in handy sometimes.
Sure.
I was impaled on a steering wheel, so I had massive internal injuries. The dashboard collapsed on my legs. My right leg was broken at the knee, and my left leg was severed just above the knee. I lost 4 inches of femur. Mm-hmm. It was just ejected from the car and never found. I put my arm up when the truck was coming for me, and when I did, it took the arm into the back seat, and from here forward was laying in the back seat of the car. So I was missing my left leg and missing my left arm, but I still have them.
Talking about your arm, you write about the pastor that came to pray with you holding your hand and how much that meant to you.
Yes.
Later on, you find out he wasn't holding your hand because, like you said, your hand was somewhere else.
That's
in
correct.
The car.
Yes.
Who was holding your hand, Don?
I believe it was an angel. I think God sent one to strengthen me and encourage me. I didn't know that till later. But I did know in the car I was holding onto a hand. But this hand, the right hand, was not anywhere near where a human could hold it.
Wow.
And so it wasn't until afterwards when I was talking to the wife of the man who prayed for me, who was an eyewitness, and I said, but I did hold the hand. And she said, of course you did. It just wasn't my husband's hand.
Mm.
And so then I knew that God had said, you know, they're around us.
Oh, yeah.
Angels are all over the place.
Mm.
And so I did hold the hand of an angel. And that's where I got the strength to get through that portion of this ordeal. But then I would need many more angels in the coming days because it would take 3 years for me to walk again and
right.
be functional.
Now, since your book came out 10 years ago, there have been so many been to heaven stories that
yes.
have come out.
Yes.
Some have been interesting.
Yes.
What are your thoughts on those? I mean, you sort of started this ball rolling and getting people fascinated about heaven.
It would seem so. Someone said it was a renaissance of heaven, you know, since the 90 Minutes was released 10 years ago. And of course, this book is an update on that. Many more details now
right.
in this book about what's happened since. I think people are hungry for hope. They want to know there's a better place than this. And let's face it, when we hear the news today and we see the things that are happening in the world, we know there's got to be a better place than this. And there is. Jesus said, I go to prepare a place for you.
Yeah.
So it's a real place. And I think people, it was kind of like an avalanche. There were these people who have had the experiences and never really planned to talk about it, like me.
Sure.
And when I did, I think it maybe kind of freed up some of the people to do that. I think some of the stories have credibility issues. But for the most part, I've had people come up to me time and time again and extend their hand and say, I've never told anybody this before.
Wow.
But that happened to me, too.
That's amazing.
Yeah.
Amazing. Well, you can find out so much more of Don's story in the best-selling book, 90 Minutes in Heaven. A special 10th anniversary version of it is in stores nationwide. I was up all night reading this. Don, thank you so much for being with us.
My privilege.
God bless you.
Honored.
And we are so happy to see you alive and well.
If I don't see you here, I'll see you there.
We'll see you. Okay.